Hey, what's up, Buck Nation? Another video I want to talk about. It's happened again. It seems like this has been a running theme with OBJ all this year. OBJ's been linked to the Bucks again. Sources say, and when I say sources, it's Von fucking Miller is the source, says that OBJ has been linked to the Buffalo Bills. He is taking up meetings with the Giants, Saints, Bucks, Bills, Packers, and Giants. Giants, Saints, Bucks, Rams, Packers, and Bills. I don't know if I said all those names right, but for his services. Now, of course, the last time we seen OBJ was in the Super Bowl when he finally broke through, got his first ever ring to finally cement his Hall of Fame career. Now, let's go to the Rams where he was playing with last year. Now, in this offseason, Rams picked up Allen Robinson. They looked at Allen Robinson from Chicago as a complimentary to Cooper Kupp. It's going to be a 1-1A type situation. You know, almost kind of like who's going to be number one? Who do you double team in that sort of way? But Allen Robinson has not lived up to expectations. And I mean that, like, literally, he's been a bust. He's like Kenny Galladay territory. He has caught nine balls in four games. Nine catches in four games. He's just been a non factor. I mean, it ain't working out. He just got the money and he ran with it. Allen Robinson's been a bust this season. OBJ had an opportunity to go to Green Bay last year and be with Davante Adams, and he could have been a 1A to Davante Adams 1 and had Aaron Rodgers backing him up as quarterback, but he chose to go to the Rams, and it was a smart decision on him because he got a ring out of it. He won, so you can't question the result of that decision. Now, the Giants. OBJ's not going to the Giants because, one, they got Daniel fucking Jones as the quarterback. You're not going with Daniel Jones. The Saints, I don't see them going to the Saints because they got Jameis fucking Winston, unless, you know, it's just not going to happen. Not with Jameis as your quarterback, I'm sorry. But the Buccaneers is interesting because him and Brady do have a relationship. And OBJ has said in the past he want to play with Brady. So they have a relationship. And also, this has been Brady's last season. And if OBJ comes to the Bucs, he will be a featured member of the offense as opposed to a Cole Beasley who got snaps because we was injured or we didn't have our full roster. OBJ come, he is definitely the number three receiver. You can bump up maybe above Julio, the way Julio has not really been that guy this season. But you look at these quarterbacks from these teams that I listed, with the exception of the Giants and the Saints, they've all been MVPs or potential MVP candidates. So OBJ has suitors that are buying for his services. So it's almost kind of like, you know, it's up to him. You know, where's the smart money? Who's the younger quarterback? We're probably going off the younger quarterback, the success. We'll see. Now, I think it's up to the Rams or the Bucks. Rams, you see, the offense is not as good as it was last year. And even when Cooper Kupp was damaging the league last year, you didn't look at the Rams as a title contender until OBJ came and got them over the hump and they became Super Bowl champion. If he goes back to the Rams with Allen Robinson struggling, he could also say 2 years in a row, I've come back and I've saved your offense and we repeated as Super Bowl champion because of me. And he can parlay that into a bigger contract with the Rams. And you can make the argument that the old OBJ from the Giants is back. Now, if you go to the Buccaneers, for one, it's Brady's last season. It's probably going to be his best chance at winning a Super Bowl as opposed to the Rams when he won last year. But this guy will probably be his best chance to win. He can do something that we never expected him to do, was win a championship back-to-back locations 2 years in a row. Not a lot of people done that. And I don't think nobody's ever done that, if I'm not mistaken. Won a ring in two different locations and back-to-back seasons. That would be unprecedented. So, you know, again, they could parlay OBA to a big contract. I'm looking at now because my daughter here. But also, the red flags for OBJ. He is coming off his second complete repair of his ACL in less than 3 years. That's always going to be red flags. Can he run? Can he move? Do you have lateral quickness? Can he separate? Can he catch? Can he take a shot to the legs, et cetera, et cetera? So his health is going to be a major factor. But at this point, it's almost kind of like, you know, it's almost kind of like with OBJ coming to the Bucs, if you get an iPhone 10 and then you buy the iPhone 11 next week, then you buy the iPhone 15 the next month, you're just adding new gadgets for Brady to play with. And if he comes, cool. If not, cool. But we'll see. Guys, thanks for watching the video. Hang on. We got a new Bucs fan here. Jalea. Hey, Buck Nation. Hey, come on, smile. Give me a smile. Come on, give me a smile, please. Hey. So this is the new member of Buck Nation. Jalea, look at the camera. All right, guys. We got some 2K to play. So I will talk to you guys later, and I will see you guys later. And like and subscribe. It all helps me help the channel. Y'all know the rest.